The thyroid gland is in your anterior neck. And it's easy to find. It's easier to find in males than females because males have a very prominent thyroid cartilage, which is also known as the Adam's apple. And females are a little bit harder to find. But it's just immediately inferior to the thyroid cartilage. When you have a physical, often your clinician will have you put their fingers on your anterior neck and ask you to swallow, and they're checking for the mobility of your thyroid gland. The thyroid gland is supplied by the superior and inferior thyroid arteries, and it is drained by the middle, inferior, and superior thyroid veins. The thyroid gland has two kinds of cells in it, and we'll talk about both types. But the thyroid gland is going to be regulated. The main part of the thyroid gland is regulated by your hypothalamus. Turn on my tool. So again, our hypothalamus is up here. It's going to secrete thyrotropin-releasing hormone into the anterior pituitary. The anterior pituitary secretes thyrotropin, and thyrotropin comes down and activates the thyroid gland to produce thyroid hormone, which is also known as T3 and T4. And the 3 and 4 have something to do with the number of iodines and things that are involved. So the thyroid gland is histologically set up in what are called thyroid follicles. And that's these circular structures here. They're a cuboidal epithelium that's arranged kind of in a big circle. And they synthesize thyroid hormone, also known as T3 and T4. And thyroid hormone then is secreted into the lumen here and is stored as something called thyroid colloid. So it's kind of like a goopy protein. And it's stored that way until the thyroid gland is acted upon by thyrotropin, and then it is taken up by the cells and then secreted into the vascular system, the capillary bed that is within the thyroid gland. The other cell type that exists within the thyroid gland are the parafollicular cells. And these cells kind of exist in between the thyroid follicles, and they secrete a hormone called calcitonin. Calcitonin lowers blood calcium. So if your blood calcium is too high, calcitonin is secreted by the parafollicular cells that then lowers your blood calcium levels by promoting the storage of calcium into bone. In summary, what I'd like you to know for the assessment is, where's the thyroid gland? Which hypothalamic releasing hormone eventually influences the thyroid gland? Which pituitary stimulating hormone directly influences the thyroid gland? What hormones or which hormones are secreted by the thyroid gland, and what are their functions? And remember, there are the thyroid follicles and the parafollicular cells. So be able to distinguish between those two cell types and what they're secreting, which one's under the influence of hypothalamus and pituitary, and which one is not. If you have a grasp on all of these concepts, then you're going to be ready for the assessment.